guys, living abroad is often the long-term goal of lots of adventure seekers. And if only it was uncomplicated as choosing a destination and grabbing your tickets. But often there's some teeny weeny details in there that you need to figure out, like lodging, visa requirements, and unless you've got some great wealthy aunt that you don't know very well throwing Benjamins your way, you've got to figure out a job. And the job can sometimes be pretty difficult. So today I'm going to talk to you a bit about all of my tips for finding a job in France. Just to give you a background on how I started working in France, I did my undergrad in the United States and I came abroad with the TAPIF program, which is a teaching assistant program in France for a year. After I finished that program, I went on to do a Master 2 in Bordeaux in marketing, which was 6 months of classes and then gave me the opportunity to intern. So I ended up interning for 18 months. So I did 3 different internships before I finally nailed my first CDI and my first job in France. I worked in a tech startup for 2 years, and then about 3 years ago I switched jobs and I'm now working for a very large cosmetics company here in Paris. I'm going to focus today on pretty general tips for looking for jobs in France. If you're looking for very concrete tips on how to improve your CV, how to improve your LinkedIn profile, websites for searching for jobs, I'm going to put all that information below in the links. I just wanted to give a shout out to also a website that I really like called Badass Careers. Rosie actually worked in HR in Paris for the last 6 years. She is from New Zealand, so she's an English speaker, and she's actually just recently moved back to New Zealand and started her own business. She gives a ton of really great career advice and a lot of free tips if you look at her Instagram or her website. So I would highly recommend, if you're looking for really operational tips, to go check that out. And here I'll give you some of the more general tips to keep you going. And last thing before we get started, I will be doing a video next week answering all of the different questions that you might have about my life and how I made it to France and what I'm doing here. So if you've got any questions that you want me to include into the video, don't hesitate to put them in the comments below. Be flexible is the first thing that I would say to you. If you're short-term goal is to live and work in France, don't also make your short-term goal have your dream job, find your Prince Charming, live in a 100-metered squared apartment that overlooks the Seine. That's too many things at once. You really need to focus and prioritize the short-term goal of just getting a job. If you find something that pays the bills, even if it's not your dream job, take it. If you've got an apartment that's not infested with rats, take it. Go on a couple of dates with some random guys who have mopeds, that's fine. Just make sure that you're prioritizing the fact that you want to live and work in France and you're not adding too many big goals on top of it. So once you can successfully say, I live and work in France, then start strategizing on how you can say, I live and work in France with my dream job. Now, speaking French is always going to be a plus on your CV, whether or not you're searching in a job market like Paris, where there are a ton of English-speaking jobs available. So if you don't speak French and you want to work in France, get serious about understanding the language. You can download any application and start playing around with different words. You can go to any of those like meetup cafes where you speak half the time in English and half the time in French. Start watching all your Netflix series in French with English subtitles if you need it to understand what's going on. Get serious about it and you'll see some improvement. The studies show that if you're able to work on your French 10 hours a day for 48 days, so that's less than 2 months, you actually can become fluent. So I'm from the camp of just get serious and motivated about it. You don't have to speak fluently French to get a job in France. I'm not saying that you should be speaking fluently within 2 months or you need to be fluent for a job. What I am saying is understanding the language is already a huge bonus for you, so that when your colleagues are in a team meeting and all of a sudden they're switching from English to French, or you're at a lunch and all of a sudden all the French people start speaking French, or you get that random email and it's in French and it's not in English because they don't know you're an English speaker, you'll at least be able to understand. Studies show that you're always going to understand reading and understand hearing before you actually can speak. So start getting your ear used to French, and already that's going to be a huge positive for you. Cool. College was great, right? Why not do it again? If you're able to, I would really, really think about heading back to school or heading to do a training. In France, a lot of master's programs are actually split into year one and year two. And if you've already done your undergraduate or a master's degree in the US, you can come over to France and you can just do the Master 2 program. It's 6 months of classes, and then it gives you the opportunity to do a 6-month internship. France has a very, very strong culture of internships and of recruiting from their pool of interns for jobs that are opening up within their company. So don't try to beat them if you can join them. Higher education is a lot cheaper in France, or if you're able to afford it, it would be great if you could get that 6 months of classes, get a 6 month internship, and then see how you can get that dream job after. What I normally hear from people is that they're too old to do internships. I'm in my late 20s. The average age of an intern is in France is 24. And so I do understand that if you are 28 or 29, I've already worked in the US, or I've already worked in another country, and I'm coming to France and I feel like my skills are undervalued, and I feel like, you know, they don't understand that I've already done, you know, a lot of really interesting things in a different field, but now I'm ready to use my transversal skills in this field. It's just not the way that the French do it. If you want to work in marketing, you need to already have experience in marketing. If you want to work in architecture, you need to already have experience in architecture. And if you don't, internships are a really great way to get it. I would say if you think you're too old for an internship, you're really just letting your ego get involved. I understand that you feel undervalued, that your skills aren't really coming through. But just look at it this way. If you do 6 months in a junior position and you're more of a senior profile, your team's gonna see what a rock star you are and you're gonna get hired afterwards. So I would say, if your long-term goal is to get hired in France, don't like turn down your nose at a possible internship and possibly going to school and then interning after. If you can't, or you don't want to go back to school and you're really desperate to move to France, find a French company with headquarters in the US. There's actually a French company in every single state in the US. So you can find a lot of opportunities to work for French companies that have headquarters in the US and can then later on send you abroad. You've got to have long-term motivation because you probably need to put in at least 3 to 5 years in the company in the US before they're actually going to transfer you over to France, but it gives you the time to understand the language, work on French, and you also have the benefit of understanding that company in the US before you're brought over to France. Plus, expat contract anyone? I heard they're pretty cushy. It sounds really cool to say that you work for well-known French companies like Chanel, and the salary might be better at Chanel, and you might have more opportunities for English-speaking roles because it's such a large company. So absolutely look in that direction, but I think it's really important, especially in Paris, who has an amazing startup scene, to also be looking at smaller companies. Don't forget that in France, you've got global healthcare, you've got your 25 vacation days no matter what, and really open yourself up to some possibilities of smaller companies, and I've stuck some links below to help you really look in more of that niche. It's not what you know, it's who you know. This could absolutely apply to a US context, but if you've lived or worked in France already, then you know that the French aren't super welcoming to newcomers all the time, and so it takes a little bit of time to make friends and to meet people, and so networking becomes very important because the French do not take recommendations lightly. If you're recommending somebody, it's because you really do believe in their skill set, you really do think that they would be an asset to the team, and you take your recommendation pretty seriously. I personally got all of my internships, except for my very first one, because I didn't have any recommendations, based on recommendations. So I went from my first internship to my second, to my third, to my first job, and to my job after that, all literally based on recommendations within that company. That's how I got my first call with the recruiters. And it's just really, really helpful. And the French put a lot of weight on this. So if you're arriving in France and you don't have a job yet, do everything you can to meet people here, to get yourself into the scene of whatever type of work you want to do, to go to conferences. Anything you can do to try to meet people that are working in your field will be really helpful. It's vital for your mental health when you're job searching to keep in mind that the job search takes a lot longer and the recruitment process takes a lot longer in France than it does in the US. On average in France, it takes 7 months to get a full-time CDI position, and you're going to pass around 4 to 5 interviews before you even secure the offer. Once you've secured the offer, you also have a trial period that can last, I think on average it's 3 to 4 months, but can go all the way up to 7 months. And then during this time, the company can decide to let you go at any point for whatever reason they want. But on the positive side, if you make it past your trial period, it is very difficult, unless you're having economic problems in the company, to get fired in France, and the government really does support you if something does happen for economic difficulties. Obviously, you can't embezzle money from the company or right hook your boss. In that case, you're on your own. But as long as you're doing your job properly on a day-to-day basis, it is a very secure job. Okay guys, I have armed you with my best tips for getting a job in France. Job searching is always very personal, so if I didn't answer some questions that you have about jobs, don't hesitate to ask me and I will get back to you in the comments below. I've also put down some links on different job sites that are well known here in France in order for searching, so don't hesitate to check those out. Keep your chin up. I don't know anybody that was determined to work in France and didn't make it happen. You just have to be more determined than all of those Frenchies telling you, c'est pas possible.